going to start playing Christmas music. It's today at 3. And I know I'm probably in the minority, but it really makes me so stupidly excited and happy. And you know what else makes me stupidly excited and happy is our upcoming production of Charlie Brown Christmas. That will be in December. It's right around the corner. It's a bunch of advanced homeschool students that I'm so very proud of and so very honored that I get to work with. My name is Dana Kretzinger, and I'm the artistic director for the Creative Spark Foundation. And I was not privileged or honored to be the actual director of the show, but I have gotten to spend some time with these kids, and they are absolutely amazing. I know because some of them have been my students in past productions, and I've gotten to see them grow and blossom. And I'm a huge fan. I'm probably their number one fan when they're quiet and they're doing what they're supposed to do backstage. Otherwise, I realize how very fortunate we are to have the opportunity to work with kids and to get to share our passions with them. And that's what's really, really special about what we do here. I've worked just about everywhere there is in Houston, and what I like the most about where we are now is the culture and the heart that we put into it. We really do love the arts, and we really do just want to see the kids grow and be sparked by that passion, at least for me personally, my passion, my love for theater arts and what it's done for my family, what it's been for my daughter who's in New York performing, and my son who performs as well. Whether or not they continue to become performing artists or professional Broadway stars or Academy Award winners, it doesn't matter because everything that they learn here will help them in whatever endeavor they do. Bedside manner, gotta be a doctor, politician. Maybe we have a future president here. They gotta be able to public speak. Work for Ronald Reagan, so. I could babble on and on and on about how important it is and how lucky I am. But I won't do that because you came here to see Cinderella. I do just want to tell you really quick about some of the upcoming things that we have. In December, on December 18th and 19th, before schools are out, we'll be having auditions for our big show for next spring, and that is Guys and Dolls. It's a beautiful, classic, iconic show, huge ensemble show, and then we will also be doing auditions for our next TYA production, which will be the Theater for Young Audiences show of Seussical the Musical, and we will be performing that for Cypher ISD students that will come here throughout end of February and the beginning of March to see the show. It's very exciting, lots of wonderful things on the horizon, and we've really only been functioning. Our first show in this theater was in June of this year, so it hasn't even been 6 months that we've been operating as a theater. Before that, we were just building it and building it and building it. I thought we would never, ever, ever be out of the dust, and there's still a lot of dust. But this is phase one, and we were able to do this with all of you guys, parents and volunteers and youth groups and Cub Scouts and you name it, Eagle Scouts, you name it, they were here and they were helping. We don't have huge investors and we don't have deep pockets. We do this surely for the love and the joy of what we're doing, and we do it with people like Shay and with people like the Maloneys and with people like you. That's how it happens. So thank you from the bottom of my heart. I'm very appreciative. Maybe it's the Christmas music in my soul that I'm feeling already, but I'm very grateful for what we do and I'm very appreciative to you. So without further ado, please support our homeschool production of Rodgers and Hammerstein's Cinderella.
Thank you. I'm you are.
I mean, you never worry about him.
Why should I worry about him?
Because he isn't happy.
Oh, he's happy, all right.
If he's so happy, why doesn't he get married?
If he's happy, why should he get married?
Look at your pants.
How could I have gained so much weight in 5 years?
Because that's all you've done for 5 years. Gained weight. You haven't worn a court costume because we haven't given a ball for 5 years. The royal tailor will have to make you another suit.
That's cost money.
Wait until you see what this ball is going to cost.
What?
Enter.
The chef, have you planned the menu for the ball?
Your Majesty!
Your Majesty!
A list of the bare necessities.
A list of bare necessities? For what?
For 1,700!
That seems a lot. Don't have any king crab.
Very well, Your Majesty.
I think you see that written on the menu. King crab, it seems like a comment on my disposition.
Baby lobster for the salad.
Wow!
And 500 pheasants for the pie.
Aye, aye.
1,000 pounds of caviar.
1,000?
Hush!
It's more than the sturgeon can supply.
I told the steward to get us 40 pigs of lettuce and 600 suckling pigs for roasting.
What about the marshmallows?
Who wants marshmallows?
I do!
What?
Should you need a side of half a glass of beef fillets?
Marble and steak, wrapped in lavender, you raise the praise. Liver, cheese, and gourmet bees, goody green and blue.
Chunks of Swiss and barrel spring, make sure it's holy
too. Puddings and pies and crumbs of clay, succulent chocolate brown.
Hurry, puff, we can eat all day.
Again, it's a royal town.
Hush.
Thank you. you know what I would do if I were you? I'd leave. If you want to be a servant, you can go somewhere and get paid. Leave my stepfamily? I don't think a father alike would like that very much. Why don't you believe in wishes and in a dream? That once in a while something marvelous and magical could happen. I don't say I don't believe that every once in a while something marvelous and magical could happen. It's just dangerous to believe in too much.
Why?
You get in the habit of sitting back and expecting things. You've got to help yourself.
I know. I always just end up wishing and dreaming. I don't suppose it does any good at all.
Do you know what I was wishing tonight? Almost afraid to hear.
I was wishing that pumpkin out in the yard would turn into a great big golden carriage and take me to the ball.
And what are you going to do for the horses?
Four white mice will turn into horses.
And were you going to drive them yourself?
Oh no, there'd be a coachman and a footman too.
Oh, I know you're going to say, oh, they're all in Billy D. Yes, Father Roll and Fiddly D.
It's impossible, I suppose.
Impossible?
Only I had a guardian angel, or a new godmother, or a fairy godmother.
Very funny.
Just the same, I am wishing, in the name of every young girl who has ever wanted to go to a dance and was told she couldn't, I'm wishing by some magic or Father Roll and Fiddly D that I could go to a ball tonight.
Impossible for a plain yellow pumpkin to become a golden carriage. Impossible for a plain
Stay down 12 o'clock. The door and the coach should not be open until the coach strikes 12.